Keep your distance, friend. Sick house is no place for a traveler.
Just help yourself to whatever you want.
Carry on.
What do you think you're doing? Oh, my mistake.
I appreciate the company and all, but you really ought to leave. You don't want to be seen around me. Because I'm sick. You don't want to associate with people in the sick house. We're not worth your time. I'm in about as much trouble as I can be. No reason you ought to be tarnished by association. People are gonna talk. Figured it was obvious. I got sick. Couldn't get better on my own. Got moved here for everyone's sake. Maybe you don't know this, but there's a real simple reason you don't talk to the plagued. You don't want what we've got. Don't. Please. People trouble. Lazy worker like me getting special treatment from some out-of-town physiker like you. People will talk. Company always tells us. Weak spirits lead to weak bodies. If I didn't want to fall sick with plague, maybe I should have worked harder. Maybe I should have taken more pride in my work. I really wish you wouldn't say those sorts of things. I'm feeling a touch faint. You've got adrena time? How? No, I don't want to know. I'm feeling a touch...
Yeah, huh? He's just interested in fixing stuff. Thomas always listened to me. Never said I was odd, never tried to... I just want to think of him like that. If he wants to learn about engineering, we should help him get those data pads he wants. Oh, I cut my own hair. Bacon?
Merciful law. Is that a marauder's outfit? I don't want you wandering into my shop wearing something you've lifted off a corpse. Please don't touch anything. Physical hygiene recapitulates moral hygiene. So everyone says. I'm Conrad. You will report to me if your hair fails to meet Spacer's Choice aesthetic standards. You will also report to me in the event of your death. Burial, in the unfortunate event of a fatality. Go ahead. The plagues come at us with a vengeance this year. Lost 6 workers in as many months. I wouldn't call them good workers, mind you. If they were any good, they'd have been treated. Still, it is a shame. Company policy, friend. We don't have enough medicine to treat all of us. So we treat the best among us. Mr. Thompson's brainchild. Have you met him yet? Thoughtful-looking fellow, stares out of his office most hours. Edgewater has been good to me. I am never wanting for work, not... As the good vicar says, work fortifies the spirit of a man.
Wish we had some better rations.
Just the way it goes, I suppose.
Something to report? We pay by the finger. Gil Antrim. Real name, Guillaume. I remember him. Was just a kid last I saw him. Shame. I'll just need your signature here, 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 and here.
Wish we had some better rations.
I know how you feel.
This is where the magic happens. Hey, that's... I mean, if you need it. If you're hungry, I could open up a can of something. My dad's... It's an office. Just my office. Flowers? I can't find many kinds around here. If you need to go, I'll wait outside. I don't like coming out here. People on the street stare.
Hey, you hear about Wilson?
Heard the wrong.
To do.
I don't have time for this.
What do you think you're doing?
What is it? We didn't always get along, but I'm glad to know she's safe. Zoe joined up with a band of marauders. Zoe. The same Zoe who doesn't know a barrel from a trigger. Well, I've heard stranger things. You pretty much did my job for me. Let me know if I can do something for you.
Anything?
I am getting old, you know. These two lamps of mine are not as bright as they once were. Or I might have seen you for what you are. Remains to be seen. Might be the man that saves the Vale. Might be Reed's personal gun hand. People around here lack the strength to effect change. Or they have the strength, but not the will. You seem to have both. I can't stop you from conducting your business down at the plant. I just want you to know that if you take our power away, you will have brought an end to our way of life.
Keep your wits about you, friend.
Any luck finding one of those manuals? No kidding! Look at that! I appreciate you going through all that trouble. In fact, I put aside something special. Well, don't keep me... Ain't that just ironical? If I'd worked a little longer back at the cannery, I might have found this myself. Two whole data pads? Be still my beating heart. Sure.
Work.
The control room should be off to the right. I hope we're doing the right thing. Nice.
System. Beginning security.
Here they come!
self-diagnostics complete. It's not the best. All systems fully operational. Hostile actions towards Spacer's choice mechanics are contrary to logical directive. In compliance with Spacer's choice policy, all defective automechanicals must be permanently dismantled. Affirmative.
Mind the steam. You're liable to get scalded.
Down they go!
Everyone all right?
Phantom!
Ah!
You're not real! You're not real! Get away from me, Phantom! Shoot! Scram!
Most people? But I'm the only one left. No. Remember your first rule, Higgins. No arguing with the Phantoms. See? See, Higgins? This is why you must always boil your sprats before ingesting. Clearly, I mistook you for one of the Phantoms of my imagination, which terrorized me on occasion. Chester D. Higgins. The D stands for definitely not insane. I use it as a reminder. Hard to say. By my reckoning, Higgins has been here somewhere between 2 weeks and forever. Oh, Higgins has been many things over the years. Sprat Wrangler, Saltuna Critic, Aetherwave Personality, Chairman of the Board, Galactic Defender, Sisty Pig Tycoon. I've come a long way for someone who started off as a simple engineer right here in this plant. Jimmy'd opened the vending machines. That lasted a good couple of months. Eventually, I had to resort to more unconventional means of filling my insides. Mechanicals lost their bolts. Opened fire on anything that moved. It was pandemonium. You mean, why did the mechanicals go on a murderous rampage? Same reason any of us do, I suppose. The voices told them to do it. I was on cleaning duty at the time. My old boss had me scrubbing pipes when the killing started. So, as usual, I missed out. I specialized in automechanicals, drones, sentries. Repaired them, maintained, upgraded. Did it all from my old workroom, just over in the next section. Look, I don't want to fall into any trouble with the mechanicals. You know, you remind me of myself back when I was an intergalactic adventurer. I discovered a flaw. Their hostility levels were hardwired to maximum. There's no changing that, but you could rewrite their targeting protocol so they attack each other instead. Yes, that's exactly it. I see you're also versed in the noble art of mechanical engineering. There's a behavior control terminal in the other room. Oh, that reminds me. You'll need my passcode to access the behavior control terminal. Here, let me just write it down for you. Funny thing. I was working on a logic module just before the mayhem started. Security chief found me and confiscated the logic module.
I could do that.
any luck finding one of those manuals? No kidding. The geothermal plant? Now that is just incredible! That's a complete set. Aside from you, Ms. Parvati.
I'm glad we could help, Thomas.
I've been saving something for you.
Bring us honor, soldier. Bang up work, soldier. You're a credit to your uniform. So this is it, then. I would reward you with the gratitude of the resistance, but I'm guessing you want something tactile.